How's it going? Hopefully all is well with you and yours. As you can see, the topic of today's video is Transvestigation 101. Porn stars are male. There is an overwhelming amount of information to go with this topic, and today's video will be focusing on the differences between male and female skeletal structures and biomarkers, the different surgeries and tricks they have been using to deceive us, and the difference between male porn stars and a real female. I expect this video to be taken down for hate speech because they hate my speech when I speak the truth about them and reveal to the world what they are. In reality, I don't hate them. I pity them. I understand that they have been extremely abused to become the empty shells of humans that they once were, and yeah, I pity them for it. But if the video gets taken down, in the description box are links to other sites with the video as well, so you can see it there. Okay, before we get into the lesson, I want to assess your transvestigation skills with a little test called Male or Female. It's a very simple test. I'm going to show you five entities with their faces blurred out, and I want you to guess if they are male or female. So in the live chat, you can just type M for male or F for female regarding whatever one you think it is. So number one, take a good look at number one here. And would you say that number one is a male or a female? Don't be shy. Please reply. Do you think number one is a girl or a guy? All right, number two. Number two, what do you think? Is number two here a male or a female? Moving on to number three. If you saw this picture on your Facebook or Instagram or whatever, would you think that is a male or a female? Number four, male or female? If you saw them walking down the beach, what would you guess? And finally, number five. Is number five a male or a female? All right, it is the moment of truth. I'm curious to see how many you got right. Thank you to those who actually participated in the test. All right, number one, hiding behind the mask is Yara Sophia, a known male drag model. Next, number two. Number two is Naomi Smalls, a known male drag model. It's pretty amazing what they can do with these surgeries and disguises. Number three. What did you say about number three? Number three is Carmen Carrera, a known male drag performer. Pretty amazing, right? Number four is April Carrion, or Carrion, I don't know, anyways. And he is a known male drag performer. I'm not sure if you noticed anything in his bikini there, but that does not look normal to me. Okay. And finally, number five. Number five is actually Derek Barry, a known male drag performer. That's pretty impressive, isn't it? Yeah. So, how many actually deceived you? That transformation is just, wow. Okay. So here we have males with drag on, okay? And these are famous porn stars. Do you notice any resemblance between the two? These are giant males in females' clothing, and these are also giant males in females' clothing. The difference between these is that these porn stars have gone through the bottom surgery. Obviously, I can't speak to any of these other ones because I don't know them. This one looks like he's tucking. But the porn stars have gone through the bottom surgery, and we'll get into all of that stuff later. Porn stars are male, every last one of them. As you will see later, putting a real girl next to them will ruin the deception. So they don't do that. For those of you with eyes to see, this picture right here in the middle says it all. It is truth in plain sight. When you are watching porn stars, you are watching two dudes getting it on, okay? This is embarrassing to your soul, and I am trying to wake you up to open your eyes to what is going on so that you can stop embarrassing your soul and become the entity that you came here to be. You didn't come here to lust and masturbate over these so-called sexy porn stars and waste your life away. You came here to do something important, and hopefully you will start to seek out that and find what it is. It's not just the porn stars that are involved in this deception agenda. It is musicians. It is models. Actresses, actors, sports stars, politicians, and even leaders of the truther community. All of these entities are deceivers playing for Team Satan. We have been through this game before, and you have experienced this entity, Patrick, before, and you know that I am speaking the truth when I tell you that he is playing for Team Satan. He is a deceiver. So, this video is originally called Transpocalypse in Their Own Words, and I have edited it for content and time, and I'll leave a link below. But these actors, actresses, celebrities, famous people, they love to put truth in plain sight and then mock humans for being too stupid to realize it. They like to make jokes and references and then try to pass it off as a joke when really the joke is the humans who continue to believe the lie.
Good evening, godless sodomites.
We're here to talk about the end of the world.
And anybody who believes that I am a man
You're clearly
obviously
a
is an
dude.
idiot.
She's a man.
He's lying! Shut up!
My mom said to me, "You know, sweetheart, one day you should settle down and marry a rich man." And I said, Mom, I am a rich man.
Give me those.
Would you prick my finger?
You're such a woman.
But you were the woman.
No, I'm the man.
But who am I?
I'm a tranny.
Who is I?
What? I'm a man.
What would surprise people about Jessica Alba?
I'm a man.
These sexy female impersonators have been deceiving you the whole time. Jessica is a male, and so is Megan Fox. All of these sexy fantasy girls you've been lusting after, they've all been dudes.
I don't know, I always feel silly. I guess men do of going, as they say, in drag, but the history of theater shows that years ago in Elizabethan times, I guess, all of the women's roles were played by men who put on women's clothes.
So and it looked great on you. You look great in red.
Raquel Welch is the last of the great Hollywood goddesses.
Do you think you're sexy?
No. I don't find myself even the littlest bit sexy.
Really?
But I can pretend.
And that is exactly what is going on. These entities are pretending that they think that they are sexy, but at the end of the day, they know that they are abominations to God. They don't have a natural, God-given body. They have a botched, just mess, okay? And when they take their clothes off at the end of the day, they know this, they see what they are, and they pretend because they are disgusted as everyone else is who sees what they are. On the other hand, a true narcissist like myself, I know I'm sexy, and I would live in a house of mirrors if I could, because I am a real female in a real female body that was given to me by my creator, and saying that any of this was done by the hands of a surgeon is just a spit in God's face, and may he forgive you for blaspheming against him, because none of this is man-made, okay?
And she was like, yeah, I look like a boy with long hair. And that's I made a PowerPoint presentation for her. And in that presentation were androgynous rock stars.
That kind of surgery can be done over the weekend.
Good evening. The Hollywood Foreign Press Association has an anal tradition. They have an anus tradition.
Good evening, godless sodomites.
This entity is not so stupid that he is not able to speak the words properly. He is saying this on purpose. They are godless sodomites. They are very focused on anything that is corrupt, and that is ultimately what sodomy is. Plus, they're a bunch of dudes, okay? Yes, there are female to males involved, and that will be a different presentation. Today we're only focusing on the male to females in particular. But, yeah, that is what these degenerates are into. And let's watch some more.
Sofia Vergara has a man jaw. Sofia
yes,
Vergara,
does.
Has anyone checked for a penis? These are from the internet.
For sure bigger than yours.
Yep. Sophia, like the other entities, is male, and, well, here is Sophia next to a real female. As you can tell, my hip sticks out a lot, and he does not have a hip at all, barely. Like, this is a dude's body. This is what it looks like when a female sticks out her hip. This is a natural curve here, an indentation. That's where I personally wear my pants. These entities like to wear high-waisted clothes, and we will get into that later, because the high-waisted clothes is one of the ways that they have been deceiving you. If they actually showed you their real hips, like I am doing, then you would know that it's a male, because they don't have flaring out hips. They can do different surgeries and stuff to disguise it, but at the end of the day, once you have the eyes to see, you will be able to see what these entities truly are.
People are kind of obsessed with you and your lovely wife, Olivia Wilde. But she's a different species.
Oh, it's a different thing.
Bone structure, skin.
Yeah, totally. I'm surprised you can, like, breed.
Teeth, eyes color, like, literally just about everything. I think, I would say my penis is better. I'll go on record saying I have a better penis than her.
Mm-hmm. I bet you $5.
You know what? You're probably right.
They're laughing because they know
tied at best. At best,
that this person's wife is actually a man.
Like, their whole, like, idea was like, we want real.
This
people.
Is also a male. So they, look at those linebacker they, like, shoulders and this thick male neck.
And then they threw us a football and they're like, play football. And
all the deep other inset eyes.
Models were like playing football like in a pretty
sloped
way.
Sloped, you know? Back male forehead.
I was, all of the photos have got a red face.
That is a male in girl's clothing. I'm like,
would Jessica Simpson, if you'd played a game of touch football with her Saturday night, and you were going to play another game with her after the game on Sunday, would it, as Terrell Owens has said, have distracted you so much that your performance on the field might have been bad? Would that really have distracted you?
No.
No.
Absolutely not. Besides, she's got man face. She's got what? She's got a man face. George. She looks like a truck driver. Give her a flat top and a mustache, a pair of engineer boots and a black leather jacket, man, you'd be scared of her.
No cookies.
All right, let's try it again. Hit it.
No, Michelle is a trans.
I'm sorry, she's a what?
A transgender. We all know.
Oh my gosh.
Oh gosh.
This little clip here was a half-truth revelation because this person goes on to say that Barack is gay, when in reality, Barack is a female and Michael is a male. So...
I feel that the royal duty, in a way, is slightly more inbred. It has
inbred.
To be.
Inbred.
It has to be trained, in a way.
But you actually seem like are. A human being.
Oh, thank you. Thanks.
Do you enjoy being a human being? Because human beings have a lot of frailty.
I do.
Shell of a human.
But it is going to bother you, because you're human. And I was human. I am human, still. But I was just referring to myself in the past. Not that I was not.
History has certainly shown that even the most intuitive criminal investigator can be wrong from time to time. But if I am mistaken, if the lieutenant is indeed a woman as she claims to be, then, my friend, she is suffering from the worst case of hemorrhoids I have ever seen! That's why Roger Podactor is dead! He found Captain Winky!
During our sex scene, I felt your dick rubbing into me.
And yes, there you have it. This is actually looks like a very male digit ratio to me. And very strong forehead. Kind of hard to see with this. But all your A-list celebrities, models, porn stars, they're all males. Many of you have already accepted the fact that there are Freemasons in and, well, kind of controlling in a way every town. So it shouldn't be that hard for you to accept the fact that there are satanic families that practice satanic ritual abuse, and they come from generations and generations and generations of deceivers. Their whole family line, going back for thousands of years, have been deceivers. So, yes, the people on the top of Satan's power pyramid are the satanic inverto puppets, which are basically completely controlled like meat puppets by the great deceiver. And they are very possessed shells of humans. Underneath them, we have real males and females with the sodomites and pedophiles and the ones who do the most corrupt things getting to the top. Here just shows the same thing, basically. We have a female to male as the rulers, presidents, and actors. We have males to male to females as your first laddies, your porn stars, your actresses. They are these sex kittens. You have the gammas, which are real females who are brought in to be the surrogates. And the deltas, the toy soldiers, the real males who are assassins, hitmen, and the four men death squads. When somebody decides to be a part of Team Satan here at the top of the pyramid, they start to fall under the same contract that Satan is contracted to our creator under. So Satan isn't Satan and his direct meat puppets, the Infertos, aren't actually allowed to directly kill anybody. They have to use real males and females like the Deltas and the females that sign up for the army or whatever to do the killing for them. All right, so Transvestigation 101. People who have studied the biological differences between males and females, like anthropologists or coroners, are able to tell if a skeleton belonged to a male or a female just by looking at different overall characteristics, features, or biomarkers. When you are transvestigating someone, you're going to want to make sure that you take in as many of the biomarkers as possible, because there are some males who have more feminine features, and there are some females, like myself, who have an athletic build, so we have more masculine features. On top of that, there are many different ways to try to, you know, surgically change the biomarkers or whatever, and we will get into that in a little bit. But first, let's look at the skull and face. The male skull tends to be wider than the female skull, and the male in general tends to have more sharp and straighter features that make him look more masculine, whereas the female tends to have more curvy and, well, softer, more feminine features. So here we have a male. You can see he has a brow ridge right here, and his head is sloped back. On the female, however, there is no brow ridge, and the forehead tends to be straight up. Males tend to have higher cheekbones than females, and sometimes you can actually see, like, the points on their cheekbones when they smile, whereas girls tend to have more soft and plump cheeks. Males tend to have a more pronounced jaw. That's what we refer to as icebreaker jaws. And here you can see how this is more curvy. And, yeah, this wide angle here is obviously masculine. Strong jawlines are a male trait. The female, on the other hand, have soft jawlines and more feminine features, obviously. Obviously, if a porn star looked like this, they would not be fooling anybody. But there are different surgeries that can be done to feminize the male face and even masculinize a female face. At this point in time, there are many people who have actually gone through these different surgeries and shared their before and after pictures. So I wanted to show you some of these transformations. They did a pretty good job with this one, don't you think? I think that they did a pretty good job on all of these, actually. Yep. Here's your classic porn star look. And, as you can see, it is a boy. Okay. You gotta wonder how many people you've passed on the street that were also deceivers. How many girls you have lusted over or fantasized about that were actually males dressed as girls. Crazy. Okay, now we're going to look at the differences between a male and female neck. As you can see here, the male neck is very wide and thick. It's pretty much straight up and down, and over here the female neck comes in more, just a little bit to make it look more feminine. Here we have two males. You'll notice how long and thick their necks are. And compared to a female neck, which comes in on the sides and is more feminine. The head and shoulder ratio between males and females is different in that for males, they have more broad shoulders, and they tend to be wide enough to fit three of his heads across. Females, on the other hand, our shoulders are more narrow, and you can generally fit about 2.5 or less of our heads next to each other across our shoulders. These are two males in dresses. See how wide their shoulders are? Okay. Female shoulders are not that wide. I've had a lot of laughs over this clip. Just, these characters are kind of funny, so I'm gonna play it.
Let's all welcome the five finalists for the 2009 Queen for of All Seasons in their swimsuit category!
Next, shoulders and hips. As you can see over here, the male shoulders are broad and the hips are narrow. It's pretty much straight up and down here, and the waist falls below the belly button. You'll notice his elbows are higher than this, whereas the female, our waist is above the belly button and our elbows are basically in the same line as that area. We have narrow shoulders and broad hips for childbirthing, and that creates this beautiful hourglass figure. Here you can see the general ratios of a male and female body. Again, we're looking at the hip, waist, and shoulders. The male waist is lower than the female's and has very narrow hips, but when a male goes through feminization surgery, they will actually take liposuction fat out of here and other areas of his body and put them down here to make him more fat and more feminine-like. Here is the before and after of the male. And even in this picture, you'll notice how long his arms look like. He looks like he has alien arms. You'll actually notice that these long alien arms are found on many of your A-list celebrities, Victoria's Secret models, other models, whatever. When a prepubescent boy is castrated, either physically or chemically with puberty blockers, his body will stay in this prepubescent state, and his arms will keep growing and growing and growing until he ends up looking like one of these alien-armed characters. You may have heard people talking and saying that person has a male or a female digit ratio. This is what they are talking about, comparing the index finger and the ring finger. This is a male, okay? A male is going to be exposed to more testosterone in the womb, and that is ultimately the amount of testosterone that you are exposed to in the womb. If you are exposed to a larger amount, you're going to have a more masculine digit ratio, and your index finger will be shorter than your ring finger. On the flip side, if you are a female and you are exposed to less testosterone in the womb, your index finger should be longer, about this or about the same height as your ring finger. And as you can see, I have a female digit ratio. I have actually seen some of your porn stars with extremely male digit ratios. Actually, I'm going to throw this up here because I'm not going to get to him this time around. But that is a masculine digit ratio. Very, very masculine, okay? So, there you have it. Alright, let's bring sexy back. What am I talking about? I'm talking about the curve of the back. When you are standing straight up and down, your hips are square to the ground, and that's what these entities are doing now. So when a male is standing straight up, he doesn't really have much of any curve at all here, whereas a female has a pretty decent size curve. You'll notice when a male stands in this position with his hips tilted down, it actually gives him the illusion of feminine curves. And you'll see that these models and actresses and porn stars even are constantly distorting their hips, trying to stick them out this way or that to give themselves the illusion of feminine curves. This is Gia Gunn, a known transsexual model, and his consultation with a surgeon talking about how they can feminize his body. What I want you to notice is that he's not walking around with his hips square to the ground like this, but rather with his bum pushed out, and you'll see him contorting, pushing his chest out like this, and sticking his bum out like this, so that it makes his masculine back look female, okay? This is me standing straight up, and I have a natural curve in my back because I'm a female. So, let's look at this guy.
Make sure that my tuck is on point so he doesn't try to take fat from there, too.
But it's getting a little bit bigger, just like from like hormonal moments.
Yeah.
So I also feel like, I don't know, if there was enough to put it more here versus here, I kind of feel like this is going to come naturally. This is not.
Yeah, no, I actually agree.
I do want my body to, like, be contorted a little bit. Mm-hmm.
There are some people that would see this entity standing here, and if I blurred out their face, they would be lusting over this entity because they've been deceived. These are some classic poses that give the illusion of feminine curves. In my years of transvesticating, looking at actresses and models and porn stars, they are constantly tilting their hips under, tilting their hips out to the side like this or like this, pushing out their chest, dropping back their shoulders, and contorting their bodies in all these different ways to try to pass. I actually have seen one of these guys with his bum out like this, his shoulders like this, his, I can't even do it, but seriously, his shoulders, this is actually Jinx Mays, one of the porn stars in this position, and I'm like, wow, dude, that's sad. But yeah, these actually are all male porn stars that you are looking at here. This video on the left here is Asunta May, which is a known transsexual model, and I'm putting him next to Victoria's Secret models so that you can see how they over-exaggerate their movements and fling their hips to the side to try to make themselves look more feminine. But in reality, they don't pass anymore. So, I also want you to notice the space between the bottom of like where their bathing suit is and how high up their belly button is. For me, this is how there's not very much space here, but you'll notice that the males are like, they have a lot longer torso than females do. So it's like there's a lot more space between the bottom of their pants and where their belly button is. Oh, should actually show you what it looks like when a real girl moves her hips to the side. You can actually still see that my hip is sticking out. You'll notice that none of these Invertoe models have this natural dip in here, okay? They all are straight down because they're males. And I am a female. These are my hips. There's no fat added here, okay? These are hips. My hips don't lie. And here we see a boy's butt walking away from us. These sodomites have gotten many, many males to be obsessed with butts. And let's just bring back the days when males liked vaginas. Sex should be sacred, and we should treat it as such instead of what these entities all try to program us with, this filthy degeneracy and negative breaking each other down instead of building each other up. When you come together to have sex with someone, it shouldn't be a degrading experience. And unfortunately, that is what these porn stars and other famous sexy female impersonators have been promoting to the public. Do you still find these entities sexy, knowing what they are? Do you still find them attractive? If you do not find them attractive anymore, then congratulations. The satanic sleeping spell that the world has been under is no longer controlling you. You're no longer under that spell. Moving down the body to the golden standard. Here we have a male pelvis, and you'll notice that it is more narrow, and this angle here is less than this angle here on the female pelvis, which is wider. We have wider hips so that we can bear children. This is from Fundamentals of Forensic Anthropology, and it says the pelvic area exhibits the greatest sexual dimorphism and can be regarded as the golden standard for sex discrimination. Visual assessment of pelvic traits is reliable enough to render metric methods unnecessary. This one's from a companion to Forensic Anthropology, and it says, there is an overall consensus that the pelvis is the most reliable skeletal element for sex estimation in humans. There are a number of morphological differences in the male and female pelvis, which can be used reliably for sex estimation. In other words, hips don't lie. Shakira has a very masculine back with these very broad shoulders, but what I notice most is this little demon face in his hair. Do you see there's a mouth there, an eye, a nose, and these reptilian-like spikes that come out occasionally like that. Yeah, very creepy. Anyways, the reason that the watchers find this song so funny is because Shakira's hips don't lie. Shakira was born a guy. Yep. And just for fun, here is male Shakira next to a real female. You'll notice that they never have this natural indentation right here. They never have an actual curving hip. They just have this. Okay, that is a male side. I wanted to show you how they can actually feminize the hips, and here's Gia Gunn, and this is part of his surgery.
Mm-hmm. We're going to start tamesing the front.
See this retracted buttocks area here? That's a male characteristic.
We'll use some of that for the breast, and I have a feeling we'll have a little extra, so I'll put a little bit more into the hip area. So her implants are in, and this is what she looks like right now.
He has dick tits right now, okay? He hasn't had the bottom surgery, and now he has fake boobs.
These will also settle.
Your A-list celebrities are this, and the porn stars at one time were this as well. They've gone through the bottom surgery, though.
Everything on our list. We like
make sure you check out this retracted area that's been filled in.
We've got a very nice shape here. Put implants in, 385s, and we put in 110 cc's of fat per side.
Crazy. So, this is what they can do from here to here. A lot more feminine with the extra fat and padding here. But once you have eyes to see, these deceivers will not be able to deceive you any longer. Another way that these deceivers deceive us is by using high-waisted clothing to hide their masculine hips, okay? I've always been completely disgusted by high-waisted clothing. It's hideous, it makes you look like a granny, gives you a granny fanny, and it's just ugly. But the reason that it is fashionable is so that these entities can all pass better. These entities, by the way, are all male porn stars. For me personally, you'll never catch me hiding my hips because my hips are so sexy and I wouldn't want to hide this. Ugh! Mmm! Now, let's talk about the genitals. Obviously, your porn stars no longer have their penis. They have gone through bottom surgery. But the majority of celebrities, your A-list celebrities, your musicians, politicians, they have not gone through the surgery like Lady Gaga. Not sure about you guys. But I don't have anything in my pants that would look like that. Laddie Gaga. Gaga. I used to call him Gag Me. Okay. Another one is Jennifer Aniston, okay? These famous celebrities, these fantasy girls that you've been lusting after are really chicks with dicks, okay? The most widely accepted deceiver is none other than First Lady Michelle Obama. Michelle Obama is not the first male First Lady, actually. In fact, all First Ladies have been male. This is Martha Washington, okay? There is nothing feminine about that, okay? And how did these deceivers even deceive us for so long? Like, wow. That is some very powerful black magic. It's not just the U.S. first laddies that are male, but also we have the rulers or wives of rulers of other countries. Here we have the first laddie of North Korea. I am not sure what that is, buddy, but I don't have anything in my pants that would make that shape. Here is the first laddie of China, the first laddie of South Africa. This is Putin's partner, and I'm really curious to where the hairline is on this entity because that is a very interesting looking forehead. Okay. Prince Diane the Man, Israel's Sarah Netanyahu, Kate Middleton with the icebreaker jaw. And finally, we have the drag one of England. Yes, there are many, many more. Those are just the ones that I looked up. For those who have not gone through the surgery, they not only tuck themselves, which sounds funny and looks just as funny, but they also have these camel toe underwear and silicone vaginas. You may be wondering, well, how do these celebrities have children that look like them? Well, you see, what we have going on in Hollywood is a bunch of male to females and a bunch of female to males. And they haven't gone through the bottom surgery yet, so they still have their functioning organs down there. And you take the sperm from one of the males, and you take the egg from one of the females, and you put them together, and then you put them in a surrogate, and voila. You have a child that looks like them, that did not actually come from their physical, through their physical body. They love to play pregnant with these moon bump fake pregnancy bellies, and this is from a movie, and it looks, I mean, it doesn't completely look real, but it's pretty realistic looking, and this is only for a movie. So you can imagine when these A-list celebrities are trying to pass, they go through greater extents. What is funny, though, is this old video of Boy Once and his pregnancy and how his belly literally smushes, okay? I don't know how many pregnant women you have been around, but when a pregnant woman sits down, her belly does not do this. This is not normal. It's actually really funny because there was a news story that covered this and they were like, oh, this Beyonce incident happened and it was her dress, yes. Beyonce is really pregnant. Like, wow, you guys are funny. You will literally show us the truth in plain sight like this, and then come up with a news story where they're covering up for the lie, and it's a very obvious lie, and then they laugh at the humans who are still dumb enough to believe it. That's the nature of our reality. Speaking of Boy Once, we have a very masculine digit ratio here. We have a sloped male forehead, a thick male neck with linebacker shoulders. This is a male, okay? A large male face, massive masculine biceps. Do you find him attractive? Let's move on. So this next 2-minute video is extremely hard to watch, so you may not want to watch it, but it's going to show you how they will turn a penis into a sort of vagina. And this is what your porn stars have gone through, and ultimately what happens is that this guy ends up with an open wound that constantly wants to close itself, and they have to keep putting things in there to keep it open. Let's see it really quick. Ugh. This is satanic, okay? At its very core. Very anti-human, very demonic activity. That right there is the hole that is being penetrated when you see these porn stars having sex. So, there you have it. And that's like the same exact image that you see with these porn stars. They have these weird looking things down there. And it may look really, really real, but at the end of the day, it's not self-lubricating like a real vagina, and they can even grow hair inside of there. Nobody is... It's not pleasurable for anybody involved when someone is having sex with a wound, so that is one of the reasons that there is such a big focus on butt sex, okay? Modern day pornography is based off of Aleister Crowley's satanic sex magic, and they involve degrading one another and doing filthy, perverted, corrupt things. Like I was saying earlier, sex is sacred and it should be treated as such. And when you are watching these porn stars and filling your mind with the filth and corruption and degeneracy that you are watching, you are corrupting your mind, body, and soul. And then for you to turn around and go into the real world and start having real females act like the boys that you're seeing on pornography, you're corrupting them too. And that's going to corrupt your soul even more. Our final section here for biomarkers is the Q angle. The Q angle here is demonstrated with this smaller angle here, and for females it is a larger angle. The reason for this difference is because us females need the space to be able to push a baby out. Males don't have this. Males aren't built to give birth because that's just not how the Creator created us, okay? Males tend to be more straight up and down and have more sharp lines, more chiseled muscles. Whereas females are more curvy. You'll notice that males don't tend to carry fat here, so a lot of times they have like straight up and down on the inside of their thighs, whereas females, we carry fat here, so this curve is created. I was actually looking at this one porn star and his upper legs were like so straight, it was ridiculous. There wasn't like any fat at all on it. I'm like, wow, you are a dude. Okay. Here you can see the dramatic angle here with the wider hips and the more narrow hips going straight up and down. And it's demonstrated here in the same manner. Wider legs going out a little bit wider, the hips going out a little bit wider. So that is the Q angle. All right, let's look at some actual porn stars. Here is Tiffany Tyler with a wide male forehead, a long male face, deep inset eyes, a male torso, and narrow male hips. This is also one of these horse faces that is a classic look. This is a boy's torso, okay? Like, how can you... There's almost an Adonis belt here. There's no natural indent where... Well, let's just see. No natural indent here at all. Even when I push my hip out to the side like he's doing, there is still an indent, okay? Tiffany Tyler is a male. And here is a real female. Goodness gracious, I'm sexy. Okay. Another one, Megan Rain. We have, well, this is truth in plain sight. They love this. Male sloped forehead. Deep inset eyes, long male face, linebacker shoulders, and a long narrow male torso. Again, there is no indent. This is a male. Here is male Megan Rain next to a sexy real girl. They're fat is in just unnatural places, and there's no hips. Like, do you not see what you are looking at? It's crazy that they have deceived everybody for so long. All right, Tori Black. We have a large sloped male forehead, an icebreaker jaw. This is one of the bigger icebreaker jaws. Like, wow, dude, you didn't get any surgery at all to shave that thing down. Holy crud. A thick male neck, linebacker shoulders, and narrow male torso and hips. Okay. Here is male Tori Black. And here is a real female. This whole pulling your shirt up above your waist thing is hideous. I would never wear that, my shirt like that normally. It's just another thing that they do to try to make themselves look girly. But you'll see again, there is not any indent here or anything as there is here. And the hip doesn't flare out. Look at this, just looks silly. We both look silly. I'm only doing it because he's doing it, and I wanted to show you what a real girl looks like. Okay, this is a boy, and this is what a real girl looks like. Look at these sexy curves. Goodness gracious. Okay. Hopefully your eyes have been opened to the truth. Unfortunately, many people are addicted to pornography and masturbation. Pornography hijacks your brain. So, yeah, there's a reason why pornography is free, and the porn that is blasted at you, the most famous porn stars, the most doing the most disgusting, degenerate, filthy, corrupt things that real, like, you realize that they are boys, right? They are sodomite boys that are broken doing these nasty things. You're not going to find real girls that are not broken, that haven't been programmed by these boys to do this. Like, it's not a natural behavior. You were broken into it by watching pornography, and other girls get it broken into it by either their boyfriend pushing it on them or them watching it themselves, which, I don't know, I've never been into watching other people have sex. It's really weird. But anyways, I would definitely encourage you to actually start to practice semen retention. Guys that practice semen retention are a lot sexier than the guys who can't control themselves and are constantly lusting over and masturbating over these dudes dressed as girls and watching pornography, okay? There are a lot of benefits of semen retention, increased energy and drive. You can even do these while you're in a relationship, okay? You can still have sex while also retaining your seed. It's actually quite fun to be with a guy who is not having an orgasm, and sex can go on for a very, very long time and can be very fun. So, yeah. I definitely encourage you to stop spilling your seed and start to see sex as the sacred act that it is and start treating it as such. I hope that you have a wonderful week. May God and the goddess bless you.
May I explain right from the start? You've always been queen of my heart. Said I'm done.